Hi, William here, your personal code monkey, and today I've got a video about JavaScript classes. I got a request from one of my Udemy students to go a bit more in depth. They're having a little trouble understanding the concept of classes, and hey, I understand it took me a while to catch on to in my early career. And it's sometimes easy to get in a comfortable place with your coding. And I had been doing functions and variables for a long time back then, and I didn't want to change. But once I got into it, it opened up a whole new world for me, and I think it will for you too. It's a great way to organize your code and save time and make your code more reusable. And JavaScript classes are rather fairly new. So even experienced JavaScript programmers have had some problems adjusting to classes. So let's dive right in.
Monkey, get up, get coffee. Code monkey, go to job.
So I have set up here an index.js file linked to an index.html with just window on load, console ready, and I'm running it in a local server, and we're just going to be using the console log today. We're not going to be using any visual elements. We're just going to run some code and look at the output and show how classes can help us to write better code and how to write those classes, and we're going to do it very quickly. Say, for example, that we wanted to write some battle code for a Dungeons and Dragons type simulation. Well, once upon a time, all we had were variables. So say, for example, var player strength equals 10 and the monster strength equals 20. And I want to do a function called attack. And then I pass in that player strength and the monster strength. But say I also need to have how much armor the player is wearing and how much armor the monster is wearing. So player armor and monster armor. Then I have to pass those into the function as well. I also need to know how much health points each character has for the player and the monster. And then I have to pass in those parameters to the attack function as well. So it gets complicated the more information I need to pass. So objects were invented. So instead of all those different variables, I could have an object, var player. And then we create an object by using brackets. And then I can say strength, 10, armor, 5, health, 100. And I don't have to put player health and player armor and player strength because it's all in this player object. And I can do the same for monster. And now instead of passing all these variables, I can simply pass the player and the monster. And then I can get rid of all these variables. And that's much nicer, cleaner code. I'll call that function and just log out some information so that you can see it is being passed. I can log out the player's health, for example, which would be 100. And I can also log out the entire player object. So objects are very great for being able to have a collection of different properties, grouping those together. You can also add functions to objects as well. And then I could call that function on the object. So where do classes come in? Well, classes are blueprints for an object. It's something we copy to make a new object or an instance of that class. Let me go ahead and now make a class called char. And we start making a class by using the class keyword, and I'm going to call it char, and that's it. That's a class. That's all it is. It's a blueprint for an object, but this is an empty class at the moment. And a class has a special function that you can add to it, and you should add it to every class, called a constructor. And a constructor is a function that is part of the object that fires when the copy is made. Console log, I am new. Now I'm going to link this into the index.html. Let me take off this player do something right now. Var player equals new char. And what that is going to do, what the new keyword does, is says make a new one, make a copy of char. Make a new copy and then fire that constructor. And then it logs out, I am new, because that copy has been made. And then we can put in values in here using the this keyword, meaning the variable that we put, this strength, belongs to this character, this class copy. This strength equals 10, and this armor equals 5, and this health equals 100. So I'm going to take away the old player code here, and I'll replace it up here with the player equals new character. And I'm going to call the attack function again. And now it logs out player not as a simple object, but as an instance of char. And it still has all of those properties in there, and it also has the do something function that we added to the player here. But now we can put that do something inside of the player class. And I'll take that code out of there, and I'll call the do something function. And there, it makes the new copy, logs out the character, and then calls the do something function and says, I will do something. So creates the character, calls the attack function, logs out the player, and then player do something. Now, what if we want to be able to do the same for Munster? We can make another class called Munster, but we can also reuse the character class. Instead of saying this strength equals 10, armor 5, health 100, we can put those in the constructor function. Strength, armor, health. And then this strength equals the local strength, the parameter strength here. This armor equals armor, and this health equals health. And the second ones here are just the parameter variables. They're local to the constructor. By putting it on this, we're saying it is a property of the character. So now we can say new character, strength of 10, armor of 5, health of 100, and that will give us the same result. Now we can make the Munster by saying var Munster equals new char 20, 10, 150. And I can take out the object there. Now, because we're making a copy of character, when I say player do something, I can also say Munster do something, because the Munster now has that do something function. Let's add one more property here called name. And this name equals name to make sure that it's a property of the character, not just a local variable here. We'll make a function called who and console log im plus name. Actually, this name, because it's a property, not a local variable. So player, new char 10, 5, 100, and name Bob. And the Munster's name can be Otto. So when we say Munster who, it will say I am Otto. Player who, I am Bob. So this saves a lot of time and it makes the code a lot neater. And then we can keep extending this by putting attack and move functions in. And then every time we do that, it will apply to not just the player, but also the Munster. So that is the basics of using classes in JavaScript. If there are any questions, please don't hesitate to ask. I hope you found this helpful. Thank you very much for watching. If you'd like to learn more about Phaser, including my ebooks, Skillshare, and Udemy courses, and tons of Phaser freebies, go to phasergames.com or click the link below in the description, and don't forget to subscribe.